First of all, let me thank Water Europe and its members for inviting me today and for the important event it has organized. Unfortunately, I cannot be with you today due to another political commitment. Let me say I feel particularly honored for being selected for your Water-Smart Society MEP Award for my work on the water reuse regulation. Water is a crucial element to preserve our citizens' well-being, and us as legislator, we have to put particular attention on its efficient use. Increasing global competition for the use of water poses a growing risk to the economy, communities, and the ecosystem they rely on. A continuous increase in demand, together with the effects of climate change, raises the alarm that there may be increasing numbers of areas subject to water scarcity. The issue of sound and efficient management of water reuse is therefore becoming increasingly pressing. Water is seen more and more as a precious and scarce resource. Europe is not an arid continent, but water supplies are now a concern for almost half of the EU population. Water scarcity is a phenomenon that affects at least 11% of the European population and 17% of the EU territory. Since 1980, the number of droughts in Europe has increased, and they have become more severe, costing around 100 billion euros over the past 30 years. This trend is destined to continue. The water scarcity is, in fact, no longer confined to a small number of areas of the continent, but is a concern for the future, for the entire Union territory. Hence, the need for the Union to find adequate solutions at European level to maintain the well-being of citizens and preserve the environment. The starting point must be to extend the principle of the circular economy also to water resources, prioritizing savings and reuse through a specific legislative instrument capable of create that regulatory stability that supports investments in this sector. For this reason, there was the need for a regulation to lay down harmonized criteria at EU level for the reuse of urban wastewater. European Parliament finally approved this regulation during last May plenary. We shared the general structure of the Commission proposal, which enhance the experience deriving from national legislation such as Italian, French and Spanish. However, as European Parliament, we thought it was necessary to intervene with some changes to make the legislation clearer, in particular on the definitions, the role and the responsibilities of the different subjects involved, and on the main risk management tasks. With regard to the minimal requirements on reclaimed water, we shared the parameters proposed by the Commission based on the study of the Joint Research Centre, which aimed to simplify administrative burdens. We also paid particular attention to the need for awareness campaigns, highlighting how important it is to save water and that reclaimed water is safe for human and animal health. We have argued the importance of fully exploiting the potential of water reuse and therefore not limiting the possible uses only for purpose of agricultural irrigation, but to have the possibility to extend it for civil and industrial purposes. The EU is facing enormous challenges, starting from the post-COVID recovery plan and the implementation of the Green Deal, which puts sustainability at the center of the EU's political action in the coming years. Today's conference goes actually in this direction. I wish you a good continuation of the work, and I hope there will be opportunities to continue our work together.